I couldn't even go to school or do anything. I had to lay down for about a And the forgiveness is all about when I heard my dad was in the residential school. He lost his leg. He was bothered by preachers and nuns. And when I heard that, I guess my dad carried so much pain inside of him that he couldn't release it to anybody. He had no help. And I had forgiven my dad ever since I heard that story that he suffered so much. There's so much pain inside of us that we carry that we don't take out. We keep it in, and we don't talk to nobody. We keep it to ourselves, thinking that we're the only ones that are going through this pain. But I forgave my dad. That's how powerful it should be. Forgive and forget. You don't know what they went through. So I sang for my dad. I didn't get a chance to sing that song, but the time is up for me. So maybe next time we meet, I will sing that song. And thanks for having me here. It was nice to be here.
Thanks for your testimony, Peter. That's what it's all about. Amazing what the Holy Spirit can do.
You know, God is so good. Very, very good. And I've been fooling around and playing a bit in the music business for about 3 years now, and I wrote an album, and I thought, well, there's no way it's not going to go anywhere, so I never bothered putting it out in the air. So February the 3rd, the Lord really prompted me. I put it out, and many radio stations have picked it up to the praise of God for that. A lot of people will hear it, and I'm going to do four of those songs from that album today. Wilford playing on it, so is Mark, and then we have a fellow that couldn't make it today, he plays steel, but he's not here today. So I'm going to start out with a song that's called Standing Somewhere in the Shadows. You know, Jesus is always there waiting for us, standing there, you know, so we'll see what happens. We'll try this.
Standing somewhere in the shadows, you'll find Jesus. He's a friend who really cares and understands. Standing somewhere in the shadows, you'll find. And you'll know him by the nail prints in his hand. He's our Savior, he's our Jesus, he's the blessed Lamb of God. He's the one who paid the precious blood for you and
Yes, you'll know him by the nail prints in his hands. Praise the Lord. Another song that I wrote is called "He's Counting on You," and it's so true that He counts on each one of us. I used to think so many times that I really can't do this. I can't sing. I can't play. But we have to step out in faith, and God does the rest. So we're going to do this one here. It's called "He's Counting on You." He counted on Peter. His gospel to preach. He counted on Paul, all nations to reach. He counted on gifts there, but we don't use them. The reason we don't use them is like I was scared. I thought, well, somebody's going to laugh at me, but then I think, what did they do to Jesus? They laughed at him. So, we're going to do one more here. This one here is, again, it's a song about Peter, but it really relates to us. What do we do with Jesus? Would we deny Jesus? Walk with him, what will we do? So we'll do this one called "Would You Like Peter, Our Lord Denied?"
Would you like Peter, our Lord denied? Or like Judas lead to? Thank you.
There's a lot of names in this world. Many each have a name. Like I go by the name of Myron Fester, but that's actually an alias. It is. You know, I'm actually Johnny Cash's cousin, and my name is Shorty Cash.
And I'm an FBI flat broke Indian.
But you know, if I had Johnny's pride and Johnny's cash, I wouldn't have a fuck going to anyone. But with all the names, seriously, I wrote a song called Jesus' Name Above All Names. And that's so true, you know, that he is... Wilford said, we're good friends, and a lot of times, you know, they come over and help them with a lot of trouble. Now I want to say a big thank you to my wife that's really been behind us, behind me, and helped me, and it's just great to have people like that in your life. Anyhow, here it goes, Jesus' name above all names. Jesus' name above all names. Jesus, Emmanuel. Jesus, King of all nations. Jesus, a story to tell. Jesus, a man of all ages. Lord, Savior, Jesus' name above all names. Everybody, Jesus, I love you. Jesus, I love you. You are my best friend. Jesus, I love you. Jesus, I love you. To me. Jesus' name above all names. You're chorus again and read it even. Jesus, Jesus, I love you.
Jesus, I love you.
You are my best friend. Jesus, I love you.
Jesus, I love you.
True to me, to the end. Praise God. He is the greatest name of all. Thank you, Jesus. Now I'm going to turn it over to somebody that can really sing.
Hello, Baron. Thank you. I just come from the Shaw Center. Many of you were there yesterday. I was there also. And what an experience it is. Emotions, the emotions that went through me. Well, I know I'm not the only one. And this morning, before I come here, I was in a sharing circle. You probably see it in the future sometimes, I don't know. But one of the keys for our healing journey now is forgiveness. Every book that you can grasp about forgiveness, take it, study it, apply it in your life, reflect it to other people. Forgiveness leaves you without mercy. Forgiveness don't happen. Without love, divine love don't happen. So the whole package is beautiful, what Jesus gave us. Forgiveness. And when you get to study forgiveness, you become stronger. You don't even realize the strength is there. And there's a, I don't know how to call it, some people call it the charisma that can reflect to other people. This is my chance in a lifetime to share. Yes, we're small, but quality is there. I want to take this chance to share with you, folks, to take home, to reconcile what next. It depends on many of, much of it, a lot of it depends on each and every one of us, what we're going to carry in our hearts. My wife is looking at me right now. You're a preacher. No, I'm just sharing what I experienced. And so much of it belongs to Jesus. It just so happens I'm a Roman Catholic, and I respect other religions, and I love other people. As long as Jesus is in there, it kind of hurt me last night. I'll have to talk about this because I forgive. Catholic bashing should not exist amongst Jesus lovers. Amen. And we forgive. You hear any guitar?
If I have been perverse, hard, or cold, if I have longed for shelter in the cold, when thou hast given me some port to hold, dear Lord, forgive. If I have one foot to go astray, if I have walked in my own will, always, dear Jesus, forgive.
Singing for Jesus, sometimes it's very tough to do. There's a fine line between you, between me and Jesus. And I need help over there to pray that I don't sing for Wilfred Collins or for the audience. If I sing for Jesus, everybody benefits. And if I make mistakes, Jesus won't laugh at me. You may laugh, but that's your problem. See, the music ministry is more than a talent. It's a gift that you were given to pray with, to evangelize. And you must respect it. You know, a lot of us are going to be going home thinking, who should I go to? My hurts are being healed. My past is going to be bye-bye. Who do I go to? soul that's sinful, make it white, whiter than snow.
But I know a man who can. Some call him Savior, the Redeemer, a woman. I call him Jesus, for he is my dearest friend. If you feel no one can help you, and your life is out of hand, well, I know a man who can. I can't walk upon the waters, overcome a raging sea, but I know a man who can. I can't cause my eyes to open, make the lame to rise up and walk again, but I know a man who can. Some call him Savior, the Redeemer of all men. I call him Jesus, for he is my dearest friend. If you feel no one can help you, and your life is out of hand, well, I know a man who can. Some call him Savior, the Redeemer of all men. I call him Jesus, for he is my dearest friend. If you feel no one can help you, and your life is out of hand, well, I know a man who can. Yes, I know of a man who can.
I've seen people throughout last night and today
We've been married for 47 years, and it's too late that I react to her remarks.
Oh. And it's too late to retreat anything else.
You know, there's a new law. You're not supposed to distract the driver.
When trouble surrounds us, and when evil comes, the body grows weak, and the spirit grows numb.
The spirit grows numb.
When these things beset us, he doesn't forget. Jesus went down to the river that day. He was baptized in the usual way. And when it was done, God blessed his son.
Oh,
Jesus wants to hear your voices.
Be
was during the Gulf War, back in the days. And the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ were in the time of mercy, period of mercy. There's a prayer that goes along with it. I'm not the inventor of it. Jesus gave it to a lady back in the 30s. I'm just a follower and a promoter of Jesus' mercy. Amen. And we want to close off with a prayer. Who would rise with me, please? Everything that we do now is for Jesus. Heavenly Father, thank you for your Son, Jesus. We ask you to teach us how to forgive. But for now, we ask you, Lord, to forgive us of all wrongs that we have done to you. And to forgive the other people that have done us wrong. The courage to go ask for forgiveness. But most of all, Lord, I need to forgive this guy, to accept him and be free of the bitter world that has resided in for a long time. And I know I'm stepping into a better world. And I praise and thank you for the people that are available today. And we praise you, Lord, for the people that are involved to give us this opportunity to say thank you, Father. Thank you. Amen.
Okay, another big warm thank you to Will Frank and Phyllis Collins, accompanied by Byron and Mark.
All right. See?
Yeah.
Thank you all.
Thank you.
Jake will be signing autographs in the washroom here in Men's Washroom. That's if you buy his CD. All right. Next we have all the way from South End, Saskatchewan, Oliver Bear. Those of you that are buying CDs, they're in the back there, $20 each on all the musicians that are here. Some of us are tired of living on Kraft dinner and flakes, so buy our CDs. All right, Oliver Bear.